Driven. Let us start with the starting system today. Starting system, you see that in an aeroplane there is an engine, right? And the engine is the one which is flying the aeroplane. But when you want to start the engine, you require a starter, right? So we are going to concentrate today only on the starter part. Okay. First, what we'll do is we'll find out what is the starting sequence. Okay. When you switch on the engine, what is the proper sequence that the pilot follows, or when the AME has to do the ground run up, what our system will follow? Okay, the system is something like this. Okay, on this y-axis, we are comparing the we are calculating the RPM, and on the x-axis, there is a time. Okay, so if you want to switch on your engine, what you're going to do is, aap pilot ki seat par baithoge, you'll sit in the cockpit, and then what you'll do is, the first thing we'll do is, we'll switch on the starter. No fuel, no ignition, nothing. Aapka sabse pehla kaam kya hai beta? Starter ko on kar dena. Once you switch on the starter, what will happen is, starter will get engaged with the gearbox, as I have already told you what happens, right? Starter gets engaged with the gearbox and the starter will start rotating. It can be electrically driven, gol 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 ghumega beta starter. As the starter is turning round and round, what it will do is it will transmit the entire torque into the compressor, right? So the compressor will also start rotating. Understood this? So the RPM of the engine starts going up. Can you see this? It is going up. Okay, at this point you will switch on the ignition. That means fuel डालने से पहले आप क्या कर रहे हो? Flame start कर रहे हो. So you will switch on the ignition as soon there is a switch. Just switch को आप operate करोगे बेटा. As soon as you will switch on the ignition, the fire wing will start and you can hear it in the cockpit. Tuck 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 करके clearly distinct आवाज आता है बेटा cockpit के अंदर when you switch on the ignition. Okay. After that you will switch on the fuel. So understanding the procedure, आप पहला fuel नहीं भेजते हो, आप पहला ignition भेजते हो and then you switch on the fuel. Okay, so now you have got ignition, you have got fuel, compressor has started rotating because of the starter. So what will happen is the engine will start rotating. It will start taking air from the front. Understood? This is what we have studied. No, there is an engine. Okay, this is what is the engine. So from here, what we are doing is we are supplying the torque. Okay, so as soon as that this is rotating better, it will rotate the compressor also. Correct? So the compressor will start rotating. As the compressor is rotating, you are taking in more amount of the air from the front. As the air is coming inside, compressor is compressing it, and then you get everything inside the combustion chamber. Fuel is available, ignition source is available, and I am supplying air from the front. All three things combine together and the engine lights up. As soon as the engine lights up, that means just see flame start work, see the shooting of EGT. EGT is exhaust gas temperature. Initially, the exhaust gas temperature is very normal. It is like whatever is the room temperature, that would be the temperature, atmospheric temperature would be indicated. And as soon as see, here you have lighted up, thode time ke baad dekho, seedha overshoot ho gaya beta. This shooting, when this shoots EGT, that is the indication for a pilot that the aircraft has started properly. Understood this? When the aircraft starts properly, only and only during that time the EGT shoots off properly. Okay, beta. So what will happen is engine has lighted up. So see, your RPM again start increasing, increasing, increasing. After some times, the engine will achieve the self-sustaining speed or self-sustaining RPM. What is this RPM? This RPM का मतलब ऐसा होता है कि now engine can sustain on its own. See. You remember when I taught you in the first class, what was it? That compressor is the one which is driving the turbine, but turbine is the one which is driving the compressor. So both of them, they require each other support, right? When the compressor compresses the pressure, then only the exhaust gases will come and rotate the turbine. And when the turbine will rotate, only then the compressor will rotate. So both of them depend upon each other. So self-sustaining RPM means what? When you connected the starter to reduce this problem, you have started it by supplying your own extra power. It starts moving and jaise hi wo ek RPM pe pahunch jata hai, to I can cut off the starter. I don't require the starter. The engine can continue. That means it will create enough pressure and it will create enough energy available to rotate this. Okay, dono ek dusre ko sustain kar sakta. That RPM is called as self-accelerating speed or self-sustaining RPM. Okay, so jaise hi self-sustaining RPM aa gaya, ignition is switched off. Okay. It is not like a piston engine. In a piston engine, what happens, beta? You have switched on the ignition and it was continuous for the duration of the time the aircraft is running. Jab tak aapka piston engine chalu hai, tab tak aapka ignition on hota hai, right? That is not the case in the jet engine. What happens in the jet engine? Once you switch on the ignition, you have to switch it off. Okay. After the engine is switched off, starter is also cut off. See, so not engine, sorry. Once the ignition is switched off, after that, starter is also switched off. And after some time, you will see that the engine achieves the ideal RPM. And you will see that the exhaust gas temperature also, they reach one peak and then they become the ideal. Understood? Let's again go through this once again. What is the starting sequence? This is a very important DGCA question. DGCA will ask you questions on the starting sequence. They will change the order and they will ask you what is the different order. Okay, so you should be able to answer them. So what is the starting sequence, beta? First, you will start the starter. Okay, when the starter is started, engine starts to rotate. Then you switch on the ignition. Then you supply it with the fuel. Once the engine light up, you will see that the exhaust gas temperature shoots. बहुत ही जल्दी इंक्रीज हो जाता है. That's an indication for the pilot that the aircraft has started, engine has started. Then after some time, engine reaches the self-accelerating speed or self-sustaining RPM. At this speed, we'll switch off the ignition. After some time, we'll switch off the starter. Starter is cut off automatically. And then the engine achieves the self-sustaining RPM, ideal RPM. DGCA has asked the question about the engine light up. When do you cut off the starter? And any sequence has been already been asked. Clear, dear? Let us go to the topic now. The main topic is finding out how the starter works and what are the different types of starter and how do we select them. So first, what we are going to do is we are going to decide how do we select a starter. Okay, what is the thing that we decide before choosing a type of a starter to be installed on the aircraft? We means manufacturer. Okay, if a manufacturer of a certain engine, let us say Rolls-Royce company, if they are making the engine, they will decide ki kaun sa type ka starter chahiye. But depending upon the following things, ye consider karke hi beta wo kar sakta. First one is the length of starting cycle. Okay, your naam mein pata chalta beta. Length of starting cycle means what? This is the entire length in which you have connected the starter, right? From here to here. So length of starting cycle means how much amount of time the starter will be connected to the engine. That is called as the length of starting cycle. Now it depends from the aircraft to aircraft. Suppose it's a commercial aircraft. So if a length of starting cycle is a little bit higher, no problem. But if it's a military aircraft, you cannot afford to have a longer starting cycle. What will happen, beta? Jitna lamba starting cycle hoga. Suppose your aircraft is sitting on the tarmac. Okay. Let us say it is sitting on the tarmac and the enemy is coming and attacking. You want your aircraft to go as soon as possible into the air. तो आपका अगर इंजन स्टार्ट होने के लिए बहुत ज्यादा टाइम लेगा बेटा, इट बिकम्स अ डिसएडवांटेज फॉर द मिलिट्री एयरक्राफ्ट. सो देयर दे शुड द दे सिलेक्ट अ शॉर्ट स्टार्टिंग साइकिल. सो डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द टाइप ऑफ द एयरक्राफ्ट एंड वेयर इट इज यूज्ड, वी विल सिलेक्ट द लेंथ ऑफ द स्टार्टिंग साइकिल. बट लेंथ ऑफ स्टार्टिंग साइकिल डज नॉट डिपेंड ओनली अपॉन दिस कि मिलिट्री की क्या है. समटाइम्स व्हाट हैपेंस इज यू आर सप्लाइंग द फ्यूल, इग्निशन भी स्टार्ट दे रहे हो, लेकिन लेंथ ऑफ स्टार्टिंग साइकिल इंक्रीज हो रहा है. उससे क्या होगा बेटा, your aircraft may have problems such as hot start and hung start. Hot start is when you have your EGT shoots up but the engine has not reached the self sustaining RPM. Dekho, the peak EGT is reached but the engine has not reached the self sustaining RPM. That type of start is called as the hot start. Hung start mein kya ho jata beta, you are supplying the fuel, you are supplying everything but engine is not attaining the self RPM in RPM bhi increase nahi ho raha aur uska temperature bhi increase nahi ho raha beta. That is called as a hung start. It takes a very long time to start the engine. Both of them are problem. We don't want that. Second one is the availability of the starting power. Availability of the starting power, you have to understand from the aspect that you have got smaller aircraft, you have got bigger aircraft. Now, naturally, anyone can think that if I have a smaller aircraft, the engine would be small and I can easily switch it on with a smaller amount of power. But if my aircraft is a very big, let us say a giant such as 787, so there your engine is so big, you have to start that engine, so you require a huge starting power, right? Clear? So starting power ka availability ke upar bhi depend karta hai beta aapka starter kaisa choose karoge. Suppose koi ek aeroplane hai 787, now 787 cannot land on the small runway, right? To wahan par aap bada bada starter laga sakte ho. Okay, but suppose there is some aircraft which lands in such a place where there is no ground facility available. Okay, jaise India mein bahut sara airport hai. Okay, let us take example of the Bombay Flying Club only. Dhule mein ek area hai beta jahan pe hamara aeroplane land hota hai, right? To wahan pe ground facilities are not available. So hame kaisa starter chahiye wahan par beta, jo hamare paas power available hai usse ho jaye, matlab battery se switch on ho jaye, waisa type ka starter chahiye. Okay, and suppose you are landing on a Mumbai airport where you have got all the facilities, so it doesn't matter ki aap kaun sa type ka starter laga rahe ho. Understood? Design feature also plays a very important role in selecting your type of startup. Okay, design feature kya hota hai beta, ki aapka weight kitna hai, simple hai ki nahi design, whether it is reliable, it should not happen that you have connected a starter and it breaks in the time. Okay, cost efficient hai ki nahi starter ko operate karna, and whether maintenance is easy or no. These are all the things that you should consider before selecting the starter. Okay, these all are important part. Let us go into the types of starter. So what we are going to do is we are going to study different types of starter. So first type of starter that we have understanding is the electrical motor starter. It is nothing but a simple electrical motor, jaise fan ke andar hota hai. Okay, we have got the motor inside the fan. You are avionics student, you already know what happens, right? There are armature winding, electricity is supplied into that, which creates a magnetic field. Armature starts to rotate. So we have got the electrical motor. Okay, question kya puchta hai beta DGCA, wo sun lo acche se. The question is, what type of electric motor you will use? We will use series wound motor. Kaun sa type ka motor use hoga beta? Series wound motor ka advantage kya hota hai beta? Series wound motor will give me high starting torque. That is another DGCA question. Okay, series wound motor gives us high starting torque, but it's make disadvantage hai beta. If it gives me high starting torque, it also consumes a lot of electricity. Okay, suppose this type of a starter is connected on the smaller aircraft, we have got a battery, ye pura ka pura battery ko drain karega to switch on the aircraft. Understood? So that is the disadvantage of electric motor starter. Normal electrical motor where you supply the electricity inside the motor starts to rotate. Jaise jaise motor rotate hoga beta, wo torque create karega. Type of motor puchta hai beta DGCA, and aapko puchta hai ki ye iska problem kya hai. So what is the problem beta? High current drain. Okay, yahan likh dete hai beta, high current drain. That means it consumes a lot of electrical power. That is the disadvantage. Understood? Let us go to the next one. Starter generator. As the name itself suggests, starter and generator. Now beta, see, it is basically an electrical motor starter only, but it has been modified to act like a generator after some time. This is an example of a picture of a starter generator. Okay, starter, as the name implies, same as electrical motor starter. Shuruaat mein aap electrical supply doge beta, the starter will start, it will rotate the engine compressor. Once the compressor reaches self-sustaining RPM, now what will happen? Once you reach the self-sustaining RPM, starter mein electric supply bhejkar power waste karoge na beta, right? So what you have to do is you have to switch off the starter, right? We have studied over here only that starter is cut off, right? So uske baad mein, this is a dead weight, no, that you are carrying in the aircraft. If you have a normal starter starter, if you have got an electrical motor starter which is on the aeroplane, that entire component, that is a dead weight. Just you are carrying it from one place to another, right? No use of that. So what the engineers decided, no, the engineers decided that we'll make the starter only act as a generator. Generator means what? Once the starting work is done, means once the engine gives enough power, once the starter gives enough power to the engine and engine reaches the self-sustaining RPM, now what will happen is the starter will cut off. But what will happen? Now it will act like a generator. We have studied AC generator, right? In which armature rotates. When the armature is rotating, it is cutting the magnetic line of force. And whenever there is a relative motion between the coil and the magnetic field, then EMF is induced. EMF kya hota beta? Current. Wahi current ko use karte hum log, usi ko generator bola jata hai. Correct? So what is happening in this type of starter? Initially, it acts like a starter, and after it has been done, it becomes a generator. So when you compare the weight, okay, yahan par aapko kya karna padega beta, ye wale aeroplane mein you will have to carry a separate starter, you will have to carry a separate generator, because you require an electrical power in the aeroplane to run the lights, cockpit ke andar ka lights, right? You require to run everything, right? So what we ensure here is that electrical requirement is done by this unit itself. That is the advantage of starter generator. So compared to the weight is of the first one, weight will reduce. Third type of the starter are the air turbine starter. These are also known as a pneumatic starter. Okay, if DGCA gives you the question, what is the pneumatic starter? Don't get confused. Pneumatic starter are nothing but the air turbine starter. Okay, now understand what happens over in this air turbine starter. Here the picture is here. Okay, let us go into the picture better. See what happens. Air, we require air to run the starter. Okay, so we take the air. Now you should ask me from where this air will come. We can supply the air from the ground supply unit. We have got a big browsers which can carry the compressed air at a high pressure that can be supplied over here. Or what you can do is you can take this air from the APU. Aeroplane ke andar APU hota hai na. So first you will switch on the APU, and from the APU you will take the bleed air. This air comes and hits the turbine. देखो किसको टर्बाइन हिट कर रहा है, इंजन का टर्बाइन नहीं हिट कर रहा है, ये स्टार्टर का टर्बाइन हिट कर रहा है. ओके, एयर इज कमिंग, इट इज हिटिंग द टर्बाइन ऑफ द स्टार्टर. ओके, व्हाट विल हैपन बिकॉज ऑफ विच द स्टार्टर विल रोटेट, इट स्टार्ट्स टू रोटेट अ वेरी हाई स्पीड, गोल 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 घूमेगा. ओके, नाउ सी द स्टार्ट दैट इज टर्बाइन इज कनेक्टेड टू द इंजन ड्राइव, इट इज कनेक्टेड टू द गियर बॉक्स, फ्रॉम द गियर बॉक्स इट विल गो एंड कनेक्ट टू द कंप्रेसर, इट विल रोटेट द कंप्रेसर, आवर वर्क इज डन. Understood? What is the advantage here? You don't require any electrical energy. Okay? What is the disadvantage? You require bleed air. Jab tak koi engine start nahi hai, you cannot get the bleed air. No? There are two or three different ways. One is the ground supply. Second one is the APU. Or what can happen is, suppose I have got four aircraft on the engine. If one engine I have switched on using the electrical power, that will start producing the bleed air. That bleed air can be used for starting the remaining engines using the air turbine starter. Understood this? In all the aircraft, air turbine starter is available. So what happens is, if suppose there are two engine aircraft, so what they will do is, on the first day of the month, that is first date, they will switch on the left engine. On the second day, that is even date, they will switch on the right engine. Third, left engine. Fourth, right engine. So that way they use the electrical power and then they use the bleed air. Cross feed karenge beta, dusre engine set into this engine. See here the supply is given. Either you can take it from the ground, either you can take it from the APU or cross bleed from the other engine. This air is coming, is ducted, goes into the air turbine starter, which is this. From here it goes inside, it rotates the turbine. As the turbine rotates, turbine is connected to the shaft, shaft also rotate. Theek hai beta? Now think about this. You are switching on the aeroplane, engine is reaching the self-sustaining RPM. What I have told you, that the starter should automatically cut off, yes or no? In this graph, when we did, we understood that here the starter is connected, but here when it reaches, we disconnect the starter. That is, starter has to be cut off. How do we achieve it? Pilot will not go physically over there and he will remove it, no? This is the component. So to remove it, we have got a clutching mechanism. So we are going to study two different types of clutch. The first one that we are going to study is called as a Paul and ratchet clutch. Okay, look over here. Before we go and study how this works, let us understand how the Paul and ratchet are actually working. This is a person. This is a Paul. Okay, Paul and ratchet mechanism. ये यहाँ पर spring loaded होता है. Okay, like this. Now what is happening is when he rotates the wheel like this. Okay, what will happen is the water bucket will start moving up. Correct, no, but it is connected over here. If you start rotating it this side, it will move up. Okay, but what will happen? A person cannot keep rotating, right? He will get tired. If he leaves his hand, what should happen? Because the weight of the water is more, the wheel should rotate in the opposite direction and go down. What happens in a normal pulley? This is a pulley. We have got a water bucket here. Okay, and you are applying the effort over here. As long as you are applying the effort, the bucket will keep coming up. Just say you are leaving the effort, you are removing the effort, the bucket will fall down inside the water. Correct? So to overcome this, we have installed a ratchet mechanism. Here what happens is, when the wheel is going in this direction, this one over here, it just sits on this. Dekho, iske upar se baitha hua hai, kuch nahi kar raha. Just say ek leg chala jayega beta, you will get this gap. Ye tuck karke niche girega. Fir upar gaya, tuck, tuck. It will keep falling one by one, step by step. Okay, and when it starts rotating in the opposite direction, what will happen is this area goes and hits this area. So we'll lock create karta hai so that the water cannot fall down. Understood? We use the same mechanism inside our jet engine starter. So this is the Paul and ratchet mechanism. Here, understand this part. The outer ring, right? In this, you will understand that this part, ye jo part hota hai, isko Paul bolte hai aur isko ratchet bolte hai. Okay. Paul is connected in the outer race. Inner race mein ratchet bana hua hai, right beta? Inner race is actually connected to your engine. Ye engine ke sath connected hai beta. Outer race is connected to the starter. So imagine what will happen. You will switch on the starter. Initially, engine mein koi power hi nahi hoga, right? So engine is not rotating, right? Only your starter is rotating. So let us say that this starter is rotating anti-clockwise like this. So when the starter rotated, beta, ye pawl jo hai, ye ratchet ke andar fix ho raha in this gap, yes or no? It goes and hit in this. This is also rotating in this direction. It will also make the engine rotate in this direction. Clear, beta? What is happening? Pawl gets engaged with what? Ratchet. So what will happen is once the outer ring is rotating, it will also rotate the inner race. Right? And the inner race is the one which is connected to the compressor, that is engine spool. So gearbox basically. So it rotates the gearbox, rotates the compressor. Understood? What will happen after some time? After some time, engine reaches the self-sustaining speed. Okay? Now the engine is accelerating. Engine is accelerating means this is connected to the engine, so it will rotate faster, right? Correct? If I don't disconnect this mechanism, what will happen is ye starter ke sath connected rahega aur starter ko bhi fast rotate karne ki koshish karega beta. So that may damage the starter. As it is rotating at a faster speed, it will also try to rotate the starter at a very high speed, which can damage the starter. So what we have to do is we have to disengage. So what is the disengaging mechanism? Once it reaches the higher RPM, this will start rotating faster. So you can imagine what is going to happen. If it starts rotating faster, it is like this. This is going ahead. This is not going at a faster rate. So ye wahi mechanism ho jayega, beta, ratcheting mechanism. One by one, it will start falling over here. You must have used the ratchet in the college, right? To open the nut and bolt, we use a ratchet so that hamara kaam kam hota hai. Once you are tightening the bolt, it will tighten. But when you move the ratchet in the opposite direction, but there is no movement of the bolt, right? Same thing is inside that. Clear, beta? So what will happen is, once the engine reaches the accelerating speed, the inner race will start traveling at a faster, ye jyada fast goal ghumega. So if it is running at a faster speed, ye to same speed se rotate ho raha hai, less speed se, what will happen is, this will start falling into the inner race, tuck, 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 aur apka kaap ho jayega. Clear, beta? The second type of arrangement that we have got is called as the sprack clutch. Look at the diagram. This is called as the sprag. Sprag is of a particular design. Iska design aisa hota na, ye wala area aur ye wala area is tarike se design kiya. Okay, here also we have got two races, the outer race, inner race. Again, outer is connected to the starter, hence it is called as a driving gear. Okay, inner is connected to the engine, hence it is called as the driven. So initially when you connect the starter, what will happen is the outer race will start moving. When the outer race is started moving, it will rotate the clutch. You just sprag and a bit, sprag is like this, pivoted at the center. It will rotate the sprag. And what will happen is, sprag will get stuck between these two places. Okay, what should happen is, pura ka pura goal khul ke, it should become cross. But it does not happen. Why? Because the shape is made in such a way that once it is rotating this, it gets stuck between this and this. So once it is stuck, outer race is rotating, so that will force the inner race to rotate. That is how you transmit the RPM from the starter to the engine. Understood? What is happening here? The outer race is rotating. Outer race ke andar there is a sprag. Sprag also rotates and it gets stuck between both the races. Outer race and inner race. Because of which what will happen is any movement that happens now in the outer race, okay, in this clockwise direction, will happen in the inner race also. Now the same thing will happen. You will supply the engine with the fuel, ignition, everything. So what will happen after that? Engine will reach the self-sustaining speed. That means now the inner race is rotating at a faster speed because engine is accelerating. But your outer race is now slowing because starter ko disengage karna, right? So if this start rotating at a faster speed, what will happen? See, it was stuck over here, right? Now this is rotating at a faster speed. So this will try to push the sprag in this direction, right? So if a sprag moves in this direction, again, this was first stuck between these two places. Now it will freely rotate between these two places. Understood? Yahan se disengage ho jayega beta, and now it will become free between both the races. So it will not transmit the RPM of this into this. So outer race will become free, inner race will become overrunning. Understood? Again, let us revise pawl and ratchet mechanism. In a pawl and ratchet mechanism, there is a ratcheting mechanism which is attached to the engine shaft, basically to the gearbox, and the outer race is attached to the starter. The RPM of the starter is connected to the outer race, so the outer race is rotating. when the outer race is rotating at a higher RPM, the ball gets engaged with the ratchet, causing the ratchet to rotate along with the ball. So if a ball is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction, ratchet will also rotate in the anti-clockwise direction. This will happen till the engine reaches a self-accelerating speed. Once the engine attains the self-accelerating speed, ratchet will start getting disengaged because ratchet will start rotating at a faster speed compared to the ball side. So it will just be kept over here. Since it is a spring load, it will keep falling at every reset. Either. That is how it becomes disengaged. In the sprag clutch, the design of a sprag is very important. First, when the outer race, which is driven by the starter, starts rotating, it rotates the sprag in such a way that it stuck the sprag between the inner race and the outer race because of the design, which causes the inner race to rotate along with the outer race. Okay. After the engine reaches the self-accelerating speed and engine starts to accelerate, now the inner race will rotate at a faster speed. Since the inner race is rotating at a faster speed, look at the design. What will happen is it will again rotate the sprag. Now this time in the opposite direction. That is, here it was rotating in the clockwise. Now he will rotate in the anti-clockwise direction. Once it rotates in the anti-clockwise direction, the sprag is made in such a way that now it will not get stuck between these two shapes. Okay, it will become free. So the outer race is free, thereby preventing a damage happening to your starter. Or you can say this is how the starter is disengaged. Okay. Let us go to the fourth type of the starter, that is called as the cartridge type or a solid propellant starter. In this, you have got one cartridge unit, you have got one breacher handle, okay, breech handle basically. Okay, what you have to do is you have to take a solid charge. Solid charge means our atom bomb, jaisa hota na, chota sa, pataka. Okay, you must have seen that rassi bomb, no? So what we do in that? We just ignite it. There is a whisk. We ignite a whisk and after some time it blasts, right? Same thing is happening over here. We have got a solid cartridge, same or not exactly like an atom bomb, but made of a same kind of a material. We keep it inside the cartridge over here. And electrically using the breacher handle will supply the power inside this. What will happen beta? It is supposed to explode, so it explodes. As it is exploding, it releases the hot gases. This gases comes outside from here and rotate the turbine. Turbine rotates at a very high speed. Okay, it will start rotating. And it is connected to the gearbox. Gearbox is connected to the engine, and that's how the engine is started. Clear? Only disadvantage of this is every time you have to start the engine, you have to put a new cartridge. Okay. Secondly, it can be very harmful also, no? If it is not contained or if there is some leakage, it is like you are exploding a small bomb inside this, right? So it's better to avoid in the civil aviation. We don't use it. Next type is the fuel air combustion starter. This type of starter I don't need to teach you in detail. You already know this. This type of starter are basically complete jet engine. Completely jet engine only, but you remove the compressor out. Understood? That means what? It is a type of a jet engine where there is a combustion chamber, there is a turbine. So what we are going to do is we are going to take air from the front. In the combustion chamber, we are going to put the fuel. Understanding this? It's something like this unit. There is a combustion chamber. So we'll take air, we'll supply fuel, and we will ignite this mixture. As you ignite this mixture, what will happen is hot gases will come out, and I will keep a small turbine over here. The turbine will start rotating. The turbine is starting rotating. Same mechanism. Turbine starts rotating, it is connected to the starter. In fact, this both are the same thing. Only difference is here we use a solid propellant as a starter. Here we use a liquid propellant as a starter. Understood? Next one is the gas turbine starter. These are nothing but a basic, very small jet engine kept inside the aeroplane to start the engine. That is called as a gas turbine starter. You can think about this, no? Beta, agar main gas turbine engine ko all this starter, they are used to start the gas turbine engine only, right? अगर मैं गैस टर्बाइन इंजन को स्टार्ट करने के लिए और एक गैस टर्बाइन स्टार्टर लगाऊंगा तो यू कैन थिंक अबाउट दिस नो ये स्टार्टर को स्टार्ट करने के लिए ही मेरे पास और एक स्टार्टर होना चाहिए राइट दैट मींस दिस विल रिक्वायर टू स्टार्टर्स सो इट बिकम्स अ मैसिव डिसएडवांटेज फॉर अस बट वी स्टिल यूज दिस टाइप ऑफ स्टार्टर इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एपीओ नॉट डायरेक्टली एज अ गैस टर्बाइन स्टार्टर ओके नेक्स्ट वन आर कॉल्ड एज द लिक्विड मोनोप्रोपेलेंट ओके दिस लिक्विड मोनोप्रोपेलेंट आर basically using hydraulics let us not do liquid monopropellant first let us do hydraulic starter so what a hydraulic starter they use the hydraulic power you know, the fluid has got a lot of power, right? So you can see over here, there is a accumulator and there is a pressurized gas over here. There is a liquid over here. When I have to switch on, I will just start the valve. As soon as I start the valve, liquid from here will come into the hydraulic starter. It will rotate the hydraulic motor faster. As the hydraulic motor is rotating, it is connected to the turbine engine that is inside the compressor gearbox. Gearbox also rotates. Understood? Very simple mechanism. Okay, but they are of the two type, energy limited and the power limited. This picture that we are seeing is the energy limited one. How we can say it is an energy limited one? Because the amount of pressure that you can get from here is as good as the pressure that is available in the accumulator. Correct? Let us say the accumulator is charged to 850 PSI. So that means what? This starter can give me only 850 PSI of PSI pressure energy, right? So energy is limited. In the power limited, what happened is, instead of connecting it with the accumulator, accumulator to hota hi hai, but along with this here, I will connect one more pump, hydraulic pump. Understood? So what happens? Hydraulic pump is connected. So hydraulic pump will generate the power and that is passing over here. Hence, it is called as the power limited. Jitna aapka power hydraulic motor de sakta hai, wo aapka kya karega beta? Turbine engine ko. See, why it is called power limited? Because if you supply, first case, you when energy limited, so you are supplying entire energy into the hydraulic motor, right? Hydraulic motor will rotate at a very high speed in the beginning. That will rotate the engine also at a very high speed. That can overshoot the power. No? Bahut zyada fast rotate ho sakta, right? So what power limited will do is, it will supply the pressure in the limited quantity. Okay, so that you get a proper starting. Jitna chahiye, utna hi power dega. Extra power dekar, engine ko problem create nahi karega. Okay. Then liquid monopropellant starter. This type of starter, you should understand liquid monopropellant. The term monopropellant means what? Monopropellant means any liquid. Okay. Any liquid which does not require external source of air or external source of oxygen to burn or for combustion is called as a monopropellant. Okay. So liquid monopropellant starter are basically like this fuel air combustion starter only. Okay, there is a combustion chamber. There is no air taken in this case. Okay, in this case, what will happen is there's only one combustion chamber where this fluid is present and we ignite it. Jo gases aayega, they are used to rotate the turbine and the turbine is used to rotate the compressor. Understood? The type of the liquid that we use are these three: concentrated hydrogen peroxide or isopropyl nitrate, or you can use hydrazine. DGCA has asked this question in many papers, which type of liquid monopropellants are used. Okay, on top also there are many DGCA question asked, but we have dealt with that. I have not told you ki specifically ki yahi pucha hai karke, but we have covered all the questions. Air impingement starter, I will say this is the best type of starter that you can get. This is nothing. कुछ भी नहीं है बेटा. ये स्टार्टर क्या करता है बेटा? एक इंजन से हवा लेता है, दैट इज क्रॉस ब्लेड एयर लेता है, और उस एयर को लेके एक्चुअल जो जेट इंजन है हमारा, उसके टरबाइन के ऊपर प्रेशर डाल देता है, एयर को डालता है, जिससे वो टरबाइन रोटेट होगा. एंड इफ दैट टरबाइन इज रोटेटिंग, दैट टरबाइन इज कनेक्टेड टू द कंप्रेसर. अंडरस्टैंडिंग व्हाट आई एम सेइंग? दिस इज माय इंजन, राइट? दिस इज द कंप्रेसर, दिस इज द टरबाइन. सो व्हाट एयर इंपिंजमेंट स्टार्टर विल डू, दे विल डायरेक्टली पुट द एयर ऑन दिस टरबाइन. Understanding, rest all the type of starter, what have we studied? Whatever power you are creating, it is used to rotate the turbine of the starter. Starter ka turbine rotate hota beta, jisse starter gol ghumta hai, and that starter ka shaft is connected to the gearbox of the engine, which rotates the engine. But only in this air impingement starter, what is happening? Air is directly coming and hitting the turbine. Understood? So this is the lightest weight and sabse most successful one. Okay, what you require? You just require small duct which carries the air from one place to the another. Okay, disadvantage of this is that you initially require the air to start the engine. Initially air nahi hoga to ye start hi nahi karega na beta. So to start first engine you require this. So what we do is we carry the APU in the aeroplane. So first we switch on the APU and from the APU we'll take the power. Or what we can do is I can switch on the left engine first and supply the power to the right engine, or I can switch on the right engine and supply the power to the left engine. Okay, the next one is the hand crank. though not used nowadays, it's very simple. Hand crank is basically what, instead of having any starter, you will have one rod which is connected and you rotate the rod. Fatafat, goal, goal, ghumaoge. What you do is now after this class, you go and search on YouTube, how is hand crank done in the jet engine? They will show you pictures. बहुत ही अच्छा वीडियो दिखाएंगे कि हाथ से गोल गोल घुमाते हैं और जैसे इंजन का पावर आ गया बेटा हैंड क्रैंक को निकालते हैं. इट इज यूज्ड ओनली ऑन द स्मॉलर एयरक्राफ्ट. बड़े एयरक्राफ्ट में हम लोग यूज नहीं कर सकते हैं बिकॉज इट इज वेरी रिस्की. सपोज यू आर स्टैंडिंग इन फ्रंट नियर द एरोप्लेन एंड यू आर ट्राइंग टू रोटेट इट यूजिंग द हैंड क्रैंक. ओके, जैसे इंजन सेल्फ सस्टेनिंग आरपीएम पे पहुंच गया, यू हैव टू रिमूव द रॉड एंड गो रन अवे फ्रॉम दैट. बट अगर आप वो नहीं कर पाए यार, जो टेक्नीशियन वहां पर है वो नहीं कर पाया, ही मे गेट कॉट इनसाइड द इंजन, राइट? हेंस वी अवॉइड हैंड क्रैंकिंग. Okay. पहले जब इनिशियल था ना वर्ल्ड वॉर टू के टाइम पे, दैट टाइम हैंड क्रैंकिंग वॉज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट. अब नहीं, अब हमारे पास स्टार्टर्स है. ग्राउंड पावर यूनिट बेसिकली ऑक्सिली. ग्राउंड पावर यूनिट क्या हो जाता है बेटा? ग्राउंड के ऊपर जो पावर सप्लाई करता है उसको हम लोग ग्राउंड पावर यूनिट बोलते हैं. इट कैन बी एन इलेक्ट्रिकल पावर, इट कैन बी न्यूमेटिक पावर, ओके, इट कैन बी ऑफ एनी टाइप. हाइड्रोलिक भी हो सकता है बेटा. तो उसके लिए क्या हो जाता है, ग्राउंड के ऊपर देर आर वेरियस ट्रक्स जो कैरी करते हैं अलग अलग टाइप का पावर. जो रिक्वायरमेंट है वो आप कॉल करोगे. जैसे आपको अगर एरोप्लेन स्टार्ट करने के इलेक्ट्रिकल पावर चाहिए, यू विल कॉल द इलेक्ट्रिकल बाउजर. इलेक्ट्रिकल बाउजर विल सप्लाई इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी. ऑक्सिलरी पावर यूनिट आर बेसिकली द एपीयू. एपीयू में आपको दो चीजें याद रखनी है बेटा. एपीयू का खुद का इग्निशन सिस्टम होता है एंड उसका फ्यूल जो सप्लाई होता है इट कैन बी अ डिफरेंट वन. मतलब खुद का अलग टैंक भी कैरी कर सकता है या फिर मेन टैंक से भी ले सकता है. एंड एपीयू इज बेसिकली अ वेरी स्मॉल जेट इंजन विच इज इंस्टॉल इन दी एम्पेनेज. एम्पेनेज मतलब क्या हो जाता है बेटा, एरोप्लेन का जो टेल कोन होता है वहां पर इंस्टॉल होता है. एपीयू डज नॉट प्रोड्यूस एनी थ्रस्ट. द फंक्शन ऑफ एपीयू इज जस्ट टू गिव द पावर टू द स्टार्टर सो दैट द इंजन कैन बी स्टार्टेड एंड इन केस ऑफ एमरजेंसी गिव द इलेक्ट्रिकल पावर टू ऑल एसेंशियल इक्विपमेंट्स. ओके, नाउ दिस चार्ट, one of the most important chart of your textbook. Okay, I have taken this extract and some of the pictures directly from this trigger book. Okay, so here there are different types of the starter written. There are advantages and there are disadvantages. What you have to do is you have to bad them thoroughly because in the examination they would be tested. Okay, so electrical motor. Electrical motor is a self-contained start possible for small aircraft. Self-contained start means you don't require any external source. If you have a battery, battery can supply. Engine may be motored for short period. Thodi der ke liye aap motor kar sakte ho without starter overheating. Okay. Engine motoring is very important because you test various equipment on the aeroplane. So motoring ka time jitna zyada hoga na utna aapke liye beneficial hota hai beta. Okay, next one. What are the disadvantages? Limited starting only for the small engines. As I told you, it cannot be used for a larger aircraft. Okay, relatively heavy for the torque produced. How we conclude this point? Because starter generator mein kya hai beta, uska use ho jata hai. So compared to that, it is of no disadvantage, right? Gear reduction gear is necessary, right? Because electrical power when you supply into the electric motor, fast rotate hota hai. Whereas your engine does not rotate at that speed. So you require reduction gear and engaging mechanism necessary. That is ball and ratchet is necessary. Starter generator, modified version of the electrical motor, right? One less accessory drive necessary. What does that mean? You don't have to carry separate generator and separate motor. Okay. You have overcut a clutch. Okay. Clutch wagera iska ye requirement hi nahi chahiye. यहाँ पे क्लच होना चाहिए ना, यहाँ पे क्लच की जरूरत ही नहीं है बिकॉज दिस नाउ विल एक्ट एज अ जनरेटर. लाइटर कंपेयर टू दिस वन. ओके, एंड सेल्फ कंटेन स्टार्ट पॉसिबल फॉर स्मॉलर एयरक्राफ्ट. अगेन डिसएडवांटेज क्या है बेटा, लिमिटेड फॉर द स्मॉल इंजन ओनली एंड रिलेटिवली हाई हैवी फॉर द टॉर्क प्रोड्यूस when operating as a starter. Sirf when operating as a starter, that time it becomes a disadvantage. But when it becomes a generator, this disadvantage is removed. एयर टर्बाइन स्टार्टर क्या था बेटा? एयर टर्बाइन स्टार्टर हवा लेते थे बाहर से, एक टर्बाइन के ऊपर डालते थे जिससे टर्बाइन रोटेट हो जाता, राइट? व्हेन द टर्बाइन रोटेट द टर्बाइन यूज्ड टू स्टार्ट. टर्बाइन इज कनेक्टेड टू द शाफ्ट, शाफ्ट इज कनेक्टेड टू द इंजन, राइट? हाई टॉर्क टू वेट रेशियो पॉसिबल. यू कैन मोटर द इंजन एट लो और हाई स्पीड. देखो यहाँ पे मोटरिंग इज पॉसिबल बिकॉज कोई पार्ट में फ्यूल डाल के गर्म नहीं कर रहे हो ना बेटा, तो फ्यूल वेस्ट नहीं हो रहा है, कुछ नहीं हो रहा है, तो आराम से आप इंजन को एक ही स्पीड पे रोटेट करते हुए रखो. मोटरिंग स्पॉट विदाउट सप्लाइंग द इंजन विद द फ्यूल, यू कीप रोटेटिंग द इंजन, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज अ मोटरिंग. सो हियर सिज द स्टार्टर इज नॉट गोइंग टू बिकम ओवरहीटेड, यू कैन कीप रोटेटिंग द इंजन एट अ हाई स्पीड. okay, without supplying the fuel, can use for a running engine. Same, agar motoring use hota to ground run ke liye bhi use hoga, right? Here, disadvantage is high volume of air supply is required. As I told you, you require high volume of air. So you require a ground units or you require one engine which is already running. Okay. Gearbox is needed and electrical connection are needed for the speed control. Agar aapko low or high speed mein rotate karna hai, to you will require electrical connection, right? Basically like a fan, slow karo, fast karo. Cartridge type, self-contained unit start is possible. Okay. For a large engine, bade engine ke liye possible hai. Very high torque to weight ratio because weight कम होता है, right? Quick start are possible. देखो इसमें quick है ना, तो ये कौन prefer करेगा बेटा? Military वाले prefer करेंगे, right? Automatic start is possible. Okay. Disadvantage, you require a cartridge for each type. Gearbox, clutch, oil are necessary and no motoring possible since आपको cartridge heat करना है. Okay. Cartridge burn होगा तो थोड़ा ही amount of power देगा ना बेटा. Suppose it can rotate the engine only for 2 minutes. Within the 2 minutes, you cannot do motoring. No, motoring करके आपको अलग-अलग test करना equipment. You cannot do that. So it cannot be used for motoring. Fuel air combustion starter. What I told you, this is basically type of gas turbine engine only, but without the compressor. In the fuel air compressor starter, self-contained start can happen. That means you can start without having any ground support. Okay. High torque to weight ratio is possible. That means it will give heavy torque and the weight is less. Automatic starts are possible. Engine can be motor for a short period of a time and interval. So ye yaad rakhna beta, yahan par DGCA pe yaad rakho ki high speed bhi de raha hai, ye sirf aapko kya hai beta, speed. Okay, only for the low RPMs. This is relatively complex. Okay, only 2 self-contained starts are possible. That means aap sirf 2 bar isko use kar sakte ho, third time isko use nahi kar sakte. Gas turbine engine starter, basically gas turbine here, right? Complete self-contained start possible because fuel up carry kar rahe ho, air carry kar rahe ho, ignition aapke paas available hai. High torque to weight ratio, long period of engine motoring possible. Good for us, right? Again, ye bhi DGCA bahut bar pucha hai beta. Okay. One of the most complex starter, isko start karne ke liye khud ek starter chahiye. Okay. Hydraulic starter chota hota hai size mein, compact in size, self-contained units are there. Okay, they can act as a pump and relatively uncomplicated. Require external power, that is the disadvantage. Monopropellant mein high starting torque, dangerous fuel. Ye fuel bahut hi dangerous hota beta. If a person comes in contact, uska haath jala sakta. Okay, so we try to avoid this. Complex system requirement. If it is a dangerous fuel, you require complex system to manage it. Air impingement starter, simplest of all the type. इसके आप motoring करते रहो, दिन रात motor करते रहो, continuous supply है, right? So motoring is easily available. Very light, can use air from the other running engine, and requires high volume of the air during the starting. That is the only problem. Hand crank, very reliable. पक्का start होगा ही ना बेटा, hand cranks आप rotate करे तो. Independent external power system, muscle चाहिए बेटा बस. Okay, muscle power chahiye, light hota hai weight mein. Limited to the small engine, cranking handle must be stored. Matlab aapne handle liya, handle se gol 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 ghumaya starter ko beta, engine start ho gaya. Fir wo starter ko aap, wo handle ko beta aapko wapis se aeroplane ke andar bhejna padega, right? Because that aeroplane is going to land in some other place. Wahan par bhi engine switch off ho sakta hai. If the engine is switched off, then again you have to start. So if they don't have the handle over there, to wahan pe engine start hi nahi hoga, right? So you require to carry the handle inside the aeroplane. That is the disadvantage. That completes the starting system. So what all things we have done? We have understood what was the starting sequence. Okay. We understood how we choose a starter. We understood different types of starter. We have studied the advantages, disadvantage. Most questions are asked only on the advantage and disadvantages. Okay. If you have any doubt on this topic, please let me know. You have my number, or alternately what you can do is you can put the doubt in the comment section. I'll get back to you, beta. Take care. Bye.